Hello guys, welcome back. It's McPlayer, and welcome back to another episode of Games on More playing server Minecraft with my friends, which is kind of alone. Anyway, I am here to show you guys there's been a lot of changes to my base, which I probably haven't got in how it actually worked before. Anyway, that's how that form finalizes. That's basically how it's going to work. It's not going to change anything. But basically, the beacon is now down there, and originally it was somewhere around here. It was somewhere higher, and now it's moved downwards a little bit because I want to make a room for it. So basically, that's what's been changed, and then. Let me just walk you guys around. Okay, so this is not changed. The water streams are originally going from here to probably but I changed it because I found there's actually room for some other stuff, and I think go upstairs here and do some stuff, and it won't interfere with this stairs, but it just doesn't fit right in because this uses stairs. Slammed. But anyway, so let's see what else. I think there hasn't been this staircase upwards. I'll show you guys. I actually just finished, kind of finished. I just started doing that, and I basically have the idea that is basically a vault. This kind of vault, and it is. For bulk storage, so I can extend the. I'll actually show you guys the first thing I've done. In these days, I've laid out this ceiling too. And basically, the biggest project I've been doing over these 2-3 days is actually I just only spent an afternoon for this, but it's basically pretty gigantic. Let you guys have a look. What this is basically a pumpkin and melon farm, and it is not 100% horseless, so you might still see some items like the ground after you harvest them, but basically the idea is there's distance here, and basically they just harvest by pushing the crops 2 times in order to like make sure get the maximum that do fall off these blocks basically. And right, I use a ton of redstone for this, and I use like the most inefficient way to get redstone up because I wanted it to look cool. But I don't know if it does. Anyway, I'm going to show you guys how it is in action. So you basically just step on this pressure plate and then so you can still see some items do flow there. Of course, you have the crop right there. You can't use this thing there and push the items down. And I think sometimes a lot of them would stack together. Of course, with recent changes, there's not actually. Basically, items would stack if they're close, and if they're near the edge like that, they were actually stacked. So, those item pile may actually contain the 4 or 5 floors above it. But basically, even though this is not 100% lossless, you still get a lot, so I don't really care. It just doesn't look aesthetically as well if you have item playing on this box. Okay, so basically this furnace room is definitely not in action. It's just I'm just doing it like the old fashioned way. I'm going to be and it's practically easier. More easier to use. port, you can use port slip. And I've changed all. Yeah, you can see I've caught quite a lot of diamonds from mining stuff. So the beacon was primarily composed of only iron and gold and emerald and diamond. Now it's purely iron. So I've caught my diamonds back. Right. So that really was the second thing. Basically, it's the vault, and also as you can find, some of the items changed. I actually changed out the whole redstone wiring behind it, so it was actually pretty good. Anyway, I'll show you the vault, and I also changed out some of the wood frames upstairs because I glided into that when I was building this. I think I will show you guys how much food storage I have right now. Look at this. Seriously, we'll never. Okay, just grab some coal. Go. Oh, okay, that's the last privilege. Anyway, we just get these guys out here. Right. And, right. So I'll just show you guys the vault. Basically, it uses observer blocks to make an elevator, basically, and then it's so I can push those like 1 hour ago. Yes, and basically, this means that it's going to have that. This actually goes up, so this stores buttons and floors. Hasn't been done yet, but you can still go down, but I have. But on the server, this doesn't work too well, especially when I'm recording. But basically, it works theoretically, but not always on the server. So basically, that's all been changed in my base. And also, we've got an enemy. But I can't show you guys right now because I don't really know where it is. But basically, I've got all my things repaired that trip to the end. But, well, now I've mined out a lot of things, like for the vaults and for that beacon room. I'll actually finish that beacon room in a second, too. So I thought I'll just follow you guys around, and I'll change this to your bottom, because I'm planning on using my base as a underground village, and I don't want to. So, yeah, let's go to Fence Space. That's bad. Okay, so he's built some more stuff. He's been using a lot of shock boxes, as you can see. There's quite a few creepers. Now I like creepers a lot. Okay, I got looting on because I switched to the small part. I dropped the bow. Anyway, I don't think there's a lot of changes here. My shop is still the same. I respect it. And I think the light levels on this prison is not too well done, so I'm not going to stay here for long. Right. I don't think there's been a lot of changes to other bases because I've been doing a lot of. I've been on the for the most part. I don't think the others have been doing a lot of things. Anyway, for the next project, I'm going to remove this tree farm and I'm going to relocate it inside a cave. Right. And basically, I want to make it more redstone, more smoke friendly with rest and stuff. But basically, I don't think there's a lot of things to tell you about the animal. Because I've been doing a lot of things. I've only been working on two projects, and I've shown you guys already. So, yeah, that's all for this video. And I hope you guys have a great day. And enjoy this. See you guys next time. Bye bye.